It's Debatable with Mark Gray here on MLBBro.com.
Welcome to Debatable, boys and girls, where we debate, deliberate, and pontificate on all things Black baseball related. Check this out. Hey, man, I know you're a beloved Mets apologist, but it seems like the season has gone in the toilet after they pretty much played Kamar Rocker. Are the Mets cursed, at least for 2021?
The Mets are cursed arguably the entirety of their history. I mean, if we're going to really keep it 100. Listen, as far as the season goes, man, I know people don't like to bring up curses, right? You know, everybody likes to look at it. It's kind of a hokey thing. But I mean, it's hard not to say that there isn't something going on. Like, it's just like the rash of injuries that we've had. I mean, from DeGrom on down has just been startling. I mean, it just feels like every week there's another significant player that's hurt. Now, Javi Baez, who we got from the Cubs. Of course, Javi Baez gets hurt when he goes to the Mets. Of course. If that doesn't tell you the Mets aren't cursed, that we get Javi Baez and instantly, I know he was hurt with the Cubs still. He was dealing with some nagging issues. But, you know, the fact that he automatically puts on the blue and orange and he gets hurt, that should tell you everything you need to know about the Mets.
You can't piss off the baseball gods, and y'all pissed off the baseball gods. You don't do Kamar Rocker like that. We talking $6 million for real. Then you put the bone out on the kid that he's got a bad UCL. Come on, that was beef between Sandy Alderson and your boy Scott Boras. So they sacrificed the end of the season. DeGrom's not going to come back. And if he come back, he's not going to be the Jacob DeGrom that you need to win the championship. And it was just a bad look, which created a bad vibe. And like you said, Javi Baez getting traded and then getting hurt. Come on, man. They're done. Mets are cursed. No debate about that. Let's go to the Olympics. Team USA, they get the silver medal. Not a bad thing in baseball, but really? They lose to a Japanese team that didn't have Yu Darvish nor Shohei Ohtani. And they lost 2-0. Is silver good enough for you, Manny Brown?
Well, listen, putting all of our American pride and xenophobia aside, I think it's good enough under the circumstances. I mean, look at it. This is not a team that you talk about. You don't have Mike Trout out there. You don't have Bryce Harper out there. You don't have, you know, all the superstar American superstars that, you know, we all know and love. So the fact of the matter is that we had a bunch of basically wash-ups and low-level minor leaguers, and we won silver. I think that's something that's commendable. I know that it's not gonna wash down, right? Because everybody expects gold medal in anything when it comes to the U.S. and it comes to the Olympics. But the fact of the matter is, you know, listen, we didn't have our superstar players playing. We didn't even have our top prospects in the sport playing, and we were able to get silver. If you throw Bryce Harper, Mike Trout, and maybe a couple other pitchers on that team, the results are completely different.
You lost 2-0 in the finals on the home turf. Granted, there were no fans in the stands, and it would have been really rocking to see how it is. Yeah. But when I'm looking out there and I'm seeing Scott Kazmir and Todd Frazier, if I hear one more story about Todd Frazier from Tom's River in the Little League World Series when we're losing. See, here's the deal, man. The demographics of the team just didn't match up to what America's about. Where were the Black American prospects? We had one Black American on the team, and then Jack Lopez represented for the Hispanic brother being from Puerto Rico. Come on, man. You got guys in the minor leagues right now that would have fit. Hey, where's my boy Buddy Reed? Is Cedric Mullins of the Baltimore Orioles an MVP candidate?
I think you have to at least throw his name out there in consideration. I mean, the guy's having a tremendous, and I knew he was having a tremendous season, but I think when you actually look at the numbers and he's been the best player on a bad Baltimore Orioles team. They're competitive. They play hard and they're competitive, but they're still a bad team. I mean, the fact that he's batting .320, 20 home runs, 40 RBIs, 21 stolen bases. He's got a 4.5 WAR, I believe. The kid has had an incredible, incredible season, really a breakout year. And I think he definitely should be in the consideration for the MVP award, especially. And you can't use the fact that he's playing on a losing team because, you know, obviously everybody's going to bring up, well, Shohei Ohtani's on the Angels and they aren't exactly the 2002 Angels over there. So, now granted, the Angels have a far better record than the Orioles. But that being said, I think this is going to be a year where I think the MVP is going to come from who just statistically has the best season. And, you know, you can make the argument if obviously Shohei's probably going to win it, but you could definitely make the argument that Cedric Mullins should be in the top three consideration.
Hey, look, it would be great for Cedric Mullins to be an MVP candidate, and you would love to see him play on a winning team. But yep. Clearly, he is a candidate. Cedric deserves to be on the medal stand. And if we can be happy with silver in the Olympics, then we got to be happy with Cedric Mullins as a potential silver medalist, man. That's debatable. Leave that wee stuff out over the plate. We're going to take you deep. Holla back.
MLBBro.com, covering black and brown major leagues.